So, well, I speed up because it's a break in. No. So, well, I don't like speaking English, and the English don't like speak when I speak in English. So, I test. But today we work to Eurosport, size 3 week, very quick. And today we speak about back practice with Apollo Server. How many people use Apollo Server? How many people work with JavaScript? Okay. So, I'm Jonathan, and I'm founder of GraphQL Paris Meetup. So you can follow me on GraphQL Paris at Twitter, or CaptainJojo42, and you can follow Eurosport. I work with GCP, Amazon Web Services, React, Node.js, and React, and GraphQL. Very quick, Eurosport in number, it's 200 countries, it's 7 billion global monthly video in view, and it's two TV shows, and it's digital. So you can see Eurosport.com is a free website with content sports. And you have Eurosport player, is all video, but it's not free. So if you have money for my my job. So the technology of Eurosport, it's GraphQL, Node.js, React, Relay. We love test, so we use Jest, and all public cloud. We work together because we work for every time in pair programming, and we have a TDD, BDD, a CI/CD, and many code review. So, Apollo Server. Many people know this this song. Is Pokemon is a new game sort 1 month, and I like that. So for all speak, I speak about Pokemon, and today we began a big trainer of GraphQL with usage of Apollo Server. We use a create a GraphQL server is very easily. And there are many functionalities, the caching, automatic persistent query for cache your HTTP request. And you can add the monitoring for the metric, for the login, for the health check directly with Apollo Server. I don't know if you know, but it's Joueur du Grenier. It's a YouTuber, a French YouTuber. And what is the difference between a good GraphQL developer or a not good GraphQL developer? The first is very easy. It's same to find your first Pokemon in the game. You have a free choice. You arrive and you create your server. In Apollo, you just need that. So you have Apollo server. We have here it's a mock for the data. We have the type. We have the resolver for the query. And after, you launch the server. You send your query in your server, and you have the response. Very easy. In 5 minutes, you are finished to create a GraphQL server. So it's good, but it's not enough. You need to use correctly a type. Here is not correct. This is better. It's the same in GraphQL. You need to use the interface, the enum, the union. I see many companies use GraphQL, but just use the scalar type, string, int, id, but don't use all the power of the GraphQL type. Here, for example, you have an interface, contents, is used for the video, for the article. With that, you just need to implement one time your resolver for content, and you have all type directly. And just on the right, on the left for you. You have NM, it's very important, and you can add directly a description for CSAT in your playground just after we create Apollo Server. So, when you use type, don't forget interface or union. For example, for the pager, I see many pagers don't use union, or it's very important to use that. Use the documentation directly in your schema. And add a custom scalar. You can find the JSON scalar directly in the GraphQL tab JSON, it's a link GitHub, and that time, for example. And when you work with Apollo, use VS Code and use the extension Apollo GraphQL. It's very easy to parse your schema. And we see that this morning, but use GraphQL Inspector or GraphQL Doctor for your pull request for see the difference between your schema and your new schema. The first trap is don't use the left join everywhere. Why? Because when you have a resolver, for example, you have a resolver for get article and an article have an image. Many people, I see that everywhere. When you have that, an article, I want an ID and content, the resolver just select start from article left join image, but you don't need the image now. So when you call that or that, the resolver is the same. It's not good. You need to that. When you have an article, you select just an article, and for the field, you need to select a field. Okay? It's more performance, and it's a good usage of GraphQL. After that, you need the... It's okay, your GraphQL is good, but you can use more implementation. You can use data sources. It's for encapsulate and fetching your data for caching, for deduplication, for error handling. And I think it's very important to use that. It's so easy. You just need, for example, for the REST API, when your resolver is just called the REST API, you can use directly Apollo Data Sources REST. You extend, and after, it's finished. We are get image, you give an ID, and this. After that, you send the data sources in your context of your API, and you can call in other resolver your image. You can see in GitHub there are SQL data sources for open source and Mongo data sources. But it's very easy to create your proper data sources. After that, you need to evaluate your GraphQL API. And for that, Facebook create Data Loader. Data Loader is a generic utility for the N+1 problem. So for that, you need Data Loader. It's for the batching and for the caching all your call. Example, you have a resolver with we want to get all article. There are S here. So you selected one from article, and we have many articles. And for all article, you need the image. So for the first, selected one image with article ID. And okay, so with that, we have many, many calls in your database, and it's not good. So if you use a data loader, the code executes that. You have an article, and you select all article, and after you select image for all article directly with where in. It's very easy to use data loader. Just you create a data loader, you give an ID, and after you can, here you see, you can get all image with ID and send directly, and all it's created by Apollo and Facebook for call correctly. For the next, I see many people don't use directive. Why? The directive is very good, very easy to use. So you have two directives directly implemented in the code, GraphQL, it's skip and deprecated. Deprecated is very useful when you have a public API. So for example here, when you have image and now the image is image HD, you need to deprecate it the first and you give the reason. When people call your API, you see the message and you can change. But it's possible to create your proper directive. For example, it's a use case directly in Apollo Server, it's a use case without sense because just for example, you want uppercase the response of your fields, So you add this directive and you resolve this directive and you uppercase the string. But when you add Apollo Server, you have directly a directive for the caching, and you can add the directive for the authentication and for the role of all feeds what you need for GET. And more, when you arrive at this tape in Pokemon is very good. So I like that. When you see Mewtwo in the first Pokemon Red, very complicated. So more and more, with Apollo, you can see, you can create your proper plugin for use the lifecycle event. It's very useful when you want to get a metric, a login directly in your GraphQL API. You can see all the requests, you can see all the response, and it's very important to use that when you use GraphQL in production. You can deploy in your project in serverless. There are many plugins in Apollo to deploy to Lambda, to Heroku, to another. And Apollo arrive with many tools, and the more popular is Apollo Engine. Is not free, the tools premium, but with that you have many information of your GraphQL API. And it's very useful when you develop. I think in production, I prefer use my directly my ELK or my CloudWatch. But for the development, it's very good and very easy to add. So after that, you're GraphQL expert. So I think it's very important to use all power of Apollo and not just create a type and a resolver. Thanks for all. It's very quick, nice. And we are here. So if you want to work in GraphQL in Paris, let's go to our spa. Thanks a lot.